Generally, I have a very short homily after the long Passion reading of Palm Sunday, and I encourage everyone to join in the services of Holy Week, the most sacred week of the church year. On one level, I can't do that this year, as churches are closed. But maybe it's even more important to encourage everyone to enter into the mystery of Holy Week as best they can, because we need the message of hope, of promise, and ultimately of resurrection that is at the core of our Christian faith. Certainly, there are online services to help with this, and I trust you have found some meaningful ones already. If you are still looking, there are some references that are being sent with this video, and the website of the Archdiocese of Baltimore, www.archbalt.org, has a whole coronavirus section with resources, and it has lots of things to check out. We know what happens in Holy Week as we will move from Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday to his being accused, arrested, taken through a mock trial, scourged and crowned with thorns, made to carry his cross, crucified, and left to die. In his humanity, Jesus dies, but 3 days later, in his divinity, he rises, conquering death and its sting. If we are struggling with the virus and the restrictions it is placing on us, imagine what a gut-wrenching experience Mary, the apostles, and the larger disciple community went through. Because we know the end of that scriptural account, we do not lose hope the same way. And we as people of faith should not lose hope today. There are those ready to enter the church who must wait a bit longer for the waters of baptism. There are so many hungering for the Eucharist that they were accustomed to receiving weekly, some even daily. There is the missing of human interaction with extended family and friends. There is fear over a sickness for which there is yet no cure. But we have faith that the world will get on the other side of this pandemic, better prepared for the future, and that we will be able to return to those things for which we now long. Let's not then forget our thirst, our hunger, our lowliness, but come out of this experience ready to work for renewal of our faith, of our relationships, and a renewal of the world around us. Please do find a way to enter into Holy Week and ask the Lord to help you know the message of emptiness and the promise of resurrection, so that when we get to Easter Sunday and the Easter season, we will have very much reason to rejoice. During that time, we will also hear the Lord's greeting his frightened friends with peace be with you. I pray that peace will be with you and your loved ones as we celebrate Easter. This is Father Donald here at Archbishop Curley High School in Baltimore, delivering that message, I trust, of hope and of peace.